Welcome to For the Love of Animals. We're very happy to have you with us today. We have so many kitties we want you to meet, and they're all different. And that's the fun of it, isn't it, Elizabeth?
Quite the assortment.
Yes, yes. Okay, now at this point, though, I'm going to ask Elizabeth to fill us in on a certain kitty. And what's her name?
Her name is Nikki.
Okay.
Nikki is a black and white female. And she's about 11 years old. She's a front paw declaw.
Okay.
Unfortunately.
Yeah.
Somebody did that to her. She's been with us for quite a while, and you won't see her at PetSmart, where we have a lot of our kitties housed. She's actually living at my home. She's been at my home for several months, and she's not here.
Right.
And she's not invisible. She's not here. She's the type of cat that does not, she's special. Let's start there.
Okay.
All right. She does not travel well, and she does not like it at PetSmart. She doesn't like new people. Okay, I'm starting with all the negatives, just throwing those out there.
That's all right.
So I couldn't bring her in today. She would not be happy. She would probably be, she has this unusual vocalization that's actually a snort. And she kind of sounds like a little piggy when she gets very upset, and we don't want to upset her.
Yeah.
So I just need to talk to you about her, and then we're also, hopefully you'll be seeing some still photographs and some videos that I've taken of her from my home, so you can get an idea. Okay, she's, you know, pretty normal cat, but there are just certain things that we need to work around due to her personality.
Okay, little crazy things.
A little crazy things, but some things are totally understandable. She doesn't like other animals, okay?
Okay.
And some cats are like that.
That's right.
Some cats are afraid of new situations.
Oh, yes.
And she's one of those. Mm-hmm. She has to be very carefully and very slowly brought into a new situation, whether it be the new home, even a new room, a new litter box, a new food.
Okay.
So we have to be careful and slow with all those things. Some cats don't like kids.
Right.
She doesn't care for kids.
Okay.
Okay,
well.
So it's like she's got all of these things that you need to work around. So she definitely needs a special home where she would be the only cat, likely the only pet.
Okay.
Of hamster
and that's
fish,
not, yeah, okay. Yeah, but that's not unusual.
Not totally unusual, but then it needs also, but you don't know, small children, even, I don't know if teens would even be a good home for her because she has, you know, cues that she will send you when she need, when people need to back off, and sometimes kids don't respect the cues.
Yeah, so an adult's only home would be what she needs?
I would say, and quiet. So we have a quiet home for her, but we don't have a catless home. We have other cats, and so she takes issue with that. And my cats take issue with her. So it's not a great situation for her. I love Nikki. I really love this cat. I'm going to cry.
No, don't cry. It's okay.
And I don't, I'd love to keep her, but she's not happy.
Yeah.
I want her to be happy.
Sure, sure.
Yeah.
So we're looking for a home for Nikki, right?
We are.
Okay.
For the right home for her.
Right.
And so it needs to be very specific. And that's why I'm, you want to communicate all of these things, but she's very loyal. Once she gets to know you and she's your buddy, she follows me around like a puppy. She needs to be with me. I work from home, so I'm at home all day. And if I happen to be sitting at my desk, she is on my chair, on the arm of my chair, and she'll sit there and she'll perch and she'll watch.
Okay.
And she'll headbutt me.
Aww.
And she'll talk to me. And the cutest thing, I've had cats all my life, but I've never had a cat that apparently liked me a lot enough to bring me their toys.
Oh, and she does?
All the time.
Oh, that's lovely.
It's so cute.
Yeah.
First, she would put them in my shoes.
Okay.
Now she brings them to me, and we have some video of her carrying her favorite toy. It's a wand toy, and it's got this long feather and a bell on the end. Now, her safe room is upstairs, and my office is downstairs. So I take all of her toys up to her safe room every night. During the day, they migrate downstairs at my feet. And I think the cutest one is the one with this yellow feather toy because it has the bell at the end. And so when she brings it down the stairs and I'm working,
you can
minding
hear it
my own business, yes, and you hear ta-ting, 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 ta-ting. It's just the cutest thing. And then she brings it over and she'll drop it at my feet and you just can't help but love it.
Oh, sure.
You know? So it just warms your heart when she does things like that.
Yeah, yeah. You're her special person, right?
I think so.
How does she respond to your husband?
Well,
does she?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes.
Does she bring him toys?
No.
Oh.
No.
Okay, so she limits it.
Yeah. At least for now.
Yeah.
Yeah, but he can pet her. You know, she'll go up to him and headbutt him when she wants some attention. He can definitely pet her. I've had people come to my home and if she doesn't know them, she'll, you know how the cats, they'll put their little ears down, right? Like the airplane ears.
Yes.
And her pupils will get real big and she'll sort of growl and you have to back off. So if somebody is interested in meeting her, don't be surprised that that is her first reaction. It takes her a long time to warm up. But when she does, she is just real sweet and loyal and we have a lot of fun together.
Oh, it sounds like
yes.
you would. Yeah. Oh, that's nice.
She's a good girl.
Yeah.
Just misunderstood.
Yeah. Okay. So tell us about the pictures now. What about the pictures you've taken of her?
Well, hopefully they'll be clear enough to see. It's hard to take pictures of cats because they are moving all the time.
Yes.
And the only camera I have right now is on the phone. It doesn't have a real quick shutter speed. So the pictures I have, some of them she likes to cuddle in a box. You know how cats like to be in enclosed spaces.
Contained,
she's in the box or she's helping me do laundry and she's in the laundry basket shedding on my clean laundry,
clean clothes,
of course.
Yes.
You know, you just can't leave anything out because she likes to claim it. Oh, her favorite place now, my husband had built a nice kitty condo and it has 3 levels.
Of course,
she has claimed the top bunk.
Oh.
That is her favorite place. So there's a couple of videos of her on there with me playing with a feather toy with her.
Okay.
So she likes that spot, or really wherever I am.
Mm-hmm. You're her person right now.
Yes.
Yes.
Right.
Yes. Okay.
And the funny thing, I just want to back up. You know, I was saying that she doesn't really care for other cats. The one cat, you know, Becca. I've got a couple of pictures of, you know, they're kind of like bookends. I'm standing at my desk here, and I've got Nikki here and Becca laying here, and they're both black and white. And she doesn't seem to mind Becca too much. So she's a female.
Okay.
But she doesn't like, she actually hates my male.
Oh.
Yes.
What does she do to show you that she hates him?
Oh, she'll do that snorting.
Oh, okay.
And growling and kind of go after him. I know she won't hurt him because she doesn't have her claws. And she has kind of small teeth. And it might be because she's an older cat, so she doesn't really bite.
Okay.
Hard.
Yeah.
She's not really going to do any damage, but you know it frightens him, and it's his home, so I feel bad for him.
Sure.
Sort of being beat up in his own home. that's not really fair to him, and I'm hoping he doesn't start having issue, too much issue, if you know what I mean.
Yes, I do.
So let's see what else. I just so with Becca, she's okay, but I think she would be most happy as an only pet.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Let's see, what else do I want to tell you about
her? Oh! Yes?
She plays hide and seek.
Does she?
She does. She's the funniest thing. So, behind the shower curtain.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, how
so
cute.
I usually have that part of the bathroom closed off.
Yeah.
But she's always looking to see when it's. She's a smart girl. I mean, she definitely knows her name. And when that part of the bathroom door is open, she dashes in into the bathtub, and she'll sit there, and she'll wait for me to play peekaboo, or she'll paw at it. That's the other thing she does when she wants to be fed, because I don't leave her food out. She's on a special diet. She does have some GI sensitivities, so we have her on a Royal Canin dry food.
Now, that's something you can purchase at any pet store, right, Royal Canin?
You know what? I get it from the vet.
Oh, okay.
But I'm not sure. It's called Select Protein.
Okay, maybe not.
I'm not 100% sure, but Royal Canin is a brand that you can normally get at any store. Maybe they'd even bring it in for you. But my other cats are on another product, so I don't fill her bowl. I'll just give her a little bit a few times a day. And when she's hungry and wants to eat, and I think I've got a video of her doing this as well. Well, she'll come to me and she'll paw my leg.
Oh, it's time to feed her.
Either that or she wants to be brushed.
Oh, really? She'll let you know if she wants to be brushed.
Yes, she wants to be brushed. She wants attention. She'll flop over. She'll show her belly.
Yeah.
It's time. It's her time.
Okay, come
on. Stop what I'm doing.
Yeah, pay attention.
Right. Yeah, so she's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Hopefully there's the right family out there for her.
Oh, yeah. So if you're interested, how can people meet her?
Oh, since she's not at PetSmart, but we'll see her on our website, the best thing to do is to give us a call. We have an answering machine, so call that's checked a couple of times a day. Let us know you're interested in meeting Nikki, and we'll make arrangements for you to come to my home to meet her.
Okay, good. Good. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. So the phone number is the Humane Haven phone number, right?
Yes.
That's what we're talking about?
Yes.
Okay, fine. 630-378-4208. And leave your name and your phone number, please, and tell us you would like more information or like to meet Nikki.
Mm.
Okay?
Yes.
Yeah, because Nikki needs a really good home, someone who's going to pay close attention to her desires.
Exactly.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Wonderful.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
You're
and
welcome.
Thank you for taking all the pictures and doing all this to help all this out.
Well, we're doing what's right for Nikki.
And you certainly are.
Okay.
You certainly are.
Thanks.
So give us a call. You can call anytime. It's a 24-hour answering machine, 630-378-4208. And someone will call you back and make whatever arrangements are necessary.
Absolutely.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Wonderful.
Thanks, Carol.
All right. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
All right. Now, this may surprise some of you, but this is really kitten season. Ha ha. Who's surprised?
Yeah.
Nobody here. Anyway, we have tons and tons of kittens right now. So if you're interested in meeting them, even the ones that we're not showing you today, please do come in to PetSmart on a Wednesday evening from 5 to 7 or a Sunday afternoon from 1 to 3. And we will be happy to introduce you to some of our kittens. Now, we have three of them here right now. Kathy, I'm going to start with you over there. Can you tell me who you've got?
I've got Easy.
Easy. That's a nice name.
She's a little girl who doesn't have any tail at all, but she's scared. It's her breed. Her mom was a Manx. Is that how you pronounce it?
Yep.
Manx mix.
Yep.
And she was born with no tail. They can be born with different lengths.
Okay.
And she has no tail whatsoever. Her sister Hip Hop has
a little bit.
Yeah, a half of a tail. And Disco is the only one with a whole tail.
Yeah, I have Disco.
This
little pretty black girl is Disco. And you can see she's got a black tail right here in front of me.
Yeah, they're just starting to get out now.
Hi.
Their mother was deserted in a house when the family moved out. And their mom was either very pregnant or had just had kittens, and they weren't found until a little while later, and some of the kittens were already gone by the time they found them in the house, deserted, and their mom was very, very thin and worked very hard to get healthy again to take care of her babies.
Mm-hmm.
So they're just now starting to get out.
Okay.
And we're looking for homes that'll never put them in that situation again.
Yeah. Okay, now tell us about Mom. Where's Mom?
Mom is in a home. Mom was adopted last week. I was so happy.
Oh, yeah.
They're all very sweet. They don't show good. They're very shy. Easy is the most shy. Disco is the most outgoing.
Yes, she is.
That's where she got her name.
She's beautiful.
She just is like a disco ball. She's forever moving and getting into everything.
And Kathy, who have you got?
I've got Hip Hop, who's not going to look at anybody right now.
She's shy.
She's comfortable here. They haven't been out for public view for very long. I think this is their second outing. So they're nervous.
Sure.
And they've already had a couple of car rides because we had them at PetSmart earlier today.
Mm-hmm.
And then brought them over here. So they're, a little bit overwhelmed on everything that's going on. But they're so sweet.
Now, about how old are they now? Do you know?
I think they're about 14 weeks old.
Okay.
14, 15 weeks old.
Okay, right in there.
They're all little girls?
All little girls.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Isn't that nice? Huh. You are just beautiful.
They're just as sweet as could be.
Yes,
they
absolutely
are very sweet. Yeah. They're lots of fun.
Do they play with each other?
Yes.
Okay, so if you're looking for two kitties, you might want to consider getting two of these.
Mm-hmm.
you know, because they would play together. They would know each other to begin with.
Yeah, hip-hop and disco are very close. Easy is a little bit more, watches from the background a little bit more. But any kitten this age would always benefit from having another cat in the house or another kitten in the house.
Yeah, yeah. Somebody to play with. Someone that they
could
play with.
And to teach them the ropes, to give them confidence.
Sure. Yeah. They have to be taught how to be cats.
They do.
Yeah, they do.
They do. You have to learn things like that.
There she is. She's looking up a little bit now. Yeah.
They're all so beautiful.
Yeah, and she's got the cutest little half tail.
Can we see it?
I don't know. She tucks it under, and it's hard to... See,
it's
know,
all right,
baby. I know, honey.
Can you turn her towards the camera if you can find her tail?
Yeah, she got it tucked under there, really.
Okay.
So, see, she got just a little bit of a tail.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
I can see it from here.
Okay,
oh, it's all right,
I
baby.
I just wanted people to see your adorable little
tail.
Yeah,
we're not making fun of you, honey.
It's got kind of a little crook on the end of it.
Okay.
Mama cat Bobby had the very distinctive Manx tail.
And which, what is that?
It's a little stub.
Okay.
You know, a little stub.
You're okay.
And, yeah, I mean, we don't know when we acquire cats, you know, if they're purebreds or not.
Sure.
So, you know, we're hesitant to say that any cat that we have is a purebred because we just don't know.
Yeah.
But she sure looked Manx.
Okay.
With that tail and, you know, her physical appearance. It's a very strong gene that she's obviously passed on to her babies. It's not unusual for them to have babies that have no tails.
Okay.
And that's not the most ideal situation because some of them can have issues. Easy's not having any problems with it. And this little girl with the half tail, no. And then
this little girl.
And she said, I don't know where I came from because I don't match the rest of my family other
That's
than
right,
my
huh?
mama was an all-black kitty and I look like her.
You have the same color as your mommy,
But they'll jump and climb and normal.
And play with each other,
And
right?
play with each other, normal kittens, absolutely.
Good.
And I think they're kind of cute with
no tail.
Their tail. Yeah, they're kind of cute that way. I don't know. There's just something
So their breed is a Manx.
Manx mix.
Manx mix. Okay.
Yeah, probably a definitely a Manx mix in there somewhere. You know, because of the gene for the tails, and because Mama looked so much like a Manx.
Okay.
There she is. She said, okay.
Oh, see, she's going to talk to you now.
She's going to talk to me. She said, what are you doing here with me?
And you're doing just fine,
But they're just sweet
you?
And adorable. And
yes,
and again, this is only their second time out, and they're very nervous. When you bring one of these little guys into your home with a lot of patience and gentleness and just lots of love, and I think they're just going to be wonderful little kitties.
A lot of handling.
Lots of handling. Mm-hmm. Gentle handling and not overwhelming because they are nervous.
Sure.
Handle them and love them and give them lots of kisses.
Did you hear that? Can we give you kisses?
You know, just being near them will make the difference in helping them get a little comfortable in their home.
Okay.
And with everything going
They're
on.
They're beautiful.
They're beautiful.
All three of them.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, these kitties are living with you right now, Kathy, right? So you won't be seeing them at PetSmart unless... You're there during regular adoption hours, Wednesday evening from 5 to 7, or Sunday afternoons from 1 to 3. If you want to be sure that you will see them, I would suggest you call the shelter and specify that you want to meet the Manx kittens.
Manx babies.
Yeah,
Manx babies.
And that way we'll be sure that Kathy brings them in that day. She's there most of the time. These kitties are there most of the time. However, there could be a time when maybe she has some other thing going on and can't
get
there.
Them there. So,
and so if you really know you want to meet these guys, let us know so we can be sure.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, but you guys are just so sweet.
They're just so sweet.
You're okay, aren't you?
She's going to fall asleep in my arms
isn't
See,
that
she's already
nice.
Getting comfortable. Easy takes the longest time to get
and
comfortable.
And this little girl here is
she's just been fine.
She's very
she
outgoing.
Has, aren't you?
Yeah. And she's getting comfy and she's settling in.
Yeah, she lets me kiss her and everything. Yeah, well, now that's about over. I shouldn't have said that. Okay, well, now you have met them.
Yeah.
Okay. And
so if you want a kitten that's a little distinctive, something that's a little different, that people can come into your house and say, what kind of cat is that?
Yeah.
You can say, well, you know, these two Well, her two.
And her two, yeah.
They're Manx mix.
Right. And you can adopt one, two, or three.
Yeah. So
absolutely.
There.
Yeah. All right. Well, thank you, ladies, very much. Okay. We'll be back in a minute some other kitties. Now we have another little girl. Seems to be Girls' Day.
It is Girls' Day today.
Okay.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Okay. So this is a little girl, mm-hmm. Judy. And who is she?
So this beauty is Bonnie. Bonnie is about 9 months old.
Mm-hmm.
And she is a very sweet girl. She is good with everything and everybody.
Good.
She loves other cats. She is fine with dogs. She is just perfect. She likes to be held. She likes to snuggle. She likes to play. So anything that you wish for in
a cat,
that's this package right here.
Yeah.
And look at her beautiful coat. She's so shiny.
Yes, she is.
And
she likes the way you're petting her.
She does. And her head is like, you can see she's still a kitten because it's so little.
Yeah.
So that will fill in. But Bonnie would be some cat that, I think you can have in a family with children.
That's what I was going to ask. Do you think she'd do well with kids?
Yes, I think absolutely.
Okay.
Because she's very affectionate, you know,
okay.
And kids tend to...
They want to hug, pick you up, and
they
want
to play a little bit.
Sure.
And then snuggle with them in the bed. That would be Bonnie.
Oh,
I have not seen anything in her that would make me think otherwise.
Okay.
So she is... Again, don't let her fool you right now. As calm as she is, she still is a kitten, so she will need playtime.
Yes.
She will need to keep, busy, too, because...
Right. And hang on to her, because she could take off at any second.
Yeah, yes. Well, she seems really relaxed with her paws right now.
Yeah,
she looks like a Black Panther. She's completely... Is she completely black? Let me see.
Yes. Black tummy?
Nothing white.
Oh, she's a...
Wow.
Look at that.
She is... Absolutely gorgeous.
Yes. Do you want to play with the mousie, huh? I brought that for you.
Yeah, look.
She's not interested.
Yeah, so we don't know much about Bonnie, about her past, but whatever it was, it shouldn't matter because she is
We have had her for a little while.
Yes.
So, and we do show her at PetSmart. She doesn't have any problems coming in there, and she's in a crate in the lobby kind of area. Outside of the adoption center, and she just is good there.
Yeah,
you know.
She seems to be totally fine wherever. You don't hear meow in the crate when you get here waits.
No,
she is just whatever whatever.
Easy going.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is really an easygoing cat. I used to have a black cat like that when I was young,
mm-hmm.
and her name was Nikki, and she was just like that.
Aww.
Just the calmest thing,
And just as pretty as can be.
Yes. So I'm assuming she likes to get brushed because...
Oh, yeah, she likes what you're doing.
Look at that. She's just enjoying this.
Hey, pretty girl.
So shiny.
Can everybody see your pretty face, huh?
Yes.
Yeah, you can look that way. Here's a mouse for you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
She's like, there's a lot of things going, but I'm just laying here... Chewing,
she's sniffing,
how beautiful
and that's
I
all.
Am.
Yeah.
Yes. And she is. She is a pretty girl.
So 9 months old. It'll be 3 months before she's a whole year old, before she's full grown, then, right?
Yes. Well, and then sometimes they fill in a little later after that, or they get...
Yeah.
Yeah. She seems like to be a little on the smaller side type of cat.
Yeah.
So she won't be a huge chimango,
Unless you overfeed her.
Well,
that's another thing that we...
Well, we hope that that's...
Yeah, we would ask you not to overfeed.
Right. And cats can be so... We have the one that's a talker. She meows all the time. There's dry food all the time, but then when it's time to wet feed, it's meow, meow. It's we haven't eaten in 5 hours, please.
Right. You know. They're like the clock for you, right? This is the time.
Yes.
Come on, where's my food?
And cats can be very, they will let you know.
Yeah.
They will let you know. So don't overfeed that pretty girl. Because she wants to stay pretty.
Yeah, she does.
So.
She does. But she's a real nice size for 9 months
she
and
is.
Everything. And
very calm.
And she's already spayed, and she has her shots, her distemper and rabies shots, and we deworm everybody when they come in.
Right.
And so she's had everything that she needs now.
And if you have other cats already in your household and you think they will be fine, she definitely will be fine.
Yeah. Definitely.
She will, because she is just, she tolerates everybody.
Yeah, she's good.
Even dogs.
And that's not always the case with cats.
No, that's true.
Yeah.
But nothing.
Okay. Yeah. Now, she's living in a home, and there is a dog in that home.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Correct.
So,
yes.
So I'm sure that has helped somewhat.
Yes. Yes.
Isn't that right, huh?
She
yeah.
is. Like, she
well, her name is Bonnie, and mm-hmm. she is available for adoption now. Mm-hmm. Okay. So if you're interested, come in and meet her.
Yes.
She's not there 24/7, but again, you can call us and come in on Wednesday evening between 5 and 7 or Sunday afternoons between 1 and 3. Thanks so much for bringing her out today.
Anytime. My pleasure.
Right. Now there's some more kittens here for you to meet. Surprised? I hope not, because there's more coming. Anyway, Kathy, now you have been handling these babies more than anybody else. Tell us about them.
Okay. I have Miney here. Miney is a black and white. I would call her a tuxedo. Mm-hmm. She's the shy one of the group, although they're all very sweet. She just takes a little longer to get into the game or whatever else is going on.
Okay.
And this is Miney.
Judy has
Miney. Meanie, sorry, Meanie. I have Meanie. Miney.
You have Miney.
See, we went backwards and confused
yes.
me. Eeny, Meanie, Miney.
Okay. All right, so who's Judy got?
So I got Miney.
Meanie.
Okay. See? Who names these cats?
Kathy did.
So Eeny, Meanie. Mm-hmm. I got Meanie.
Yeah. Meanie's, she's beautiful.
Yes.
She's got her fur's a little bit longer, isn't it?
Yes, it is. It's just, she looks fluffy.
Yeah.
See?
Yeah.
She has like medium length hair.
Yeah.
She is
yeah.
very, very fluffy and
yeah.
cute.
Very
oh my God,
pretty.
Is she cute?
Is she purring?
Yes, she is, but her heart beats very
oh, yeah.
fast.
Yeah, so they're very nervous
they're
being
nervous
in front of
here,
the cameras.
But look yeah. how cute she is. Oh,
yes.
my gosh. She's shaking.
Yes. Okay, and I have Eeny. Okay, so Eeny is gorgeous. Look at her.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't she beautiful?
Eeny seems to like this here. No? Is she...
What?
She seems to like it. No?
Yeah.
She's the most outgoing of the group. She's the first to try anything new.
Okay.
She seems to have more confidence than her sisters.
Okay. Yeah, she's lovely. Now, she didn't jump out of a carrier and say, hold me. I mean, we had to pick her up and say, hang on, kid.
Yeah.
You're not going anywhere. So,
oh,
anyway.
How they, old are they?
They're about 13 weeks old.
Okay. So 13 weeks, they're babies yet. They are really babies. But they're as sweet as can be. They are available now for adoption. If you're interested in meeting them, not you don't have to say, oh, I want that one, I'm going to adopt it. Come in and meet them and see what they're like, see how handleable they are for you.
And they might be a little nervous too, right? When
sure.
they're out. So sometimes it takes a little bit, you
yeah.
know, when they're like out at PetSmart, we see that with cats. Mm.
Oh,
often.
Yeah.
You know, you meet the cat and the cat is a little standoffish or
yeah.
shy. That doesn't mean that is the personality of
That's
the
right.
cat.
That's
it's
right.
It's just the circumstances, you know.
Sure.
I mean, I know my cats would freak out in public.
Oh, mine
because
too.
They're not used to it. And
yeah.
so are these not. So that's
yeah.
why they're a little nervous. Huh. And mm.
You're
you know,
a baby, aren't you? Yes.
And so don't let that, you know, just come and
yeah,
meet.
Just come and meet them and see what they're like.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah,
okay.
Give them a little time to relax so you could
right.
get to know them, because people will do that. Oh, that one's shy. I don't want to meet them.
Yeah,
right.
That's not right.
Putting the cat in the carrier, taking it for a car ride, then unloading it, putting it in a crate.
Noise.
That's all very
that noise.
Yeah, that's
and
all very
then,
upsetting.
Then taking it out of the crate and handing it to somebody they've never met before.
Oh,
you know,
yeah.
And you have dogs barking,
right.
you have people talking,
mm-hmm.
and it's just totally
it's really
out
traumatic.
Of their element.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah.
And they will be different as soon as they settle in
oh, yeah.
home, you know.
Sure.
That's why we always say the safe room thing. Get used to one thing, get used to the smells and sounds of the
oh,
house.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Before you release
okay.
them to the whole house.
Right,
and
right.
just imagine
just
them
a safe
being
room is what they need.
Of the area that is. And
yeah.
You know, of course they get nervous.
Okay,
but
so these are three beautiful girls, and they would like to meet you, I'm sure. So give us a call or just show up, and we'd be happy to have you meet them. Thank you, ladies, for being here to help today.
You're welcome.
Now we have a gorgeous, gorgeous boy here we want you to meet. And he is full grown, I believe, right, Kathy?
He should be about full grown,
mm-hmm.
A young adult, somewhere between 1 and 2 years old.
Okay.
So he's a youngster.
He's young.
His
yeah.
name is Strider.
Mm-hmm.
And he's a kind of a medium hair. Very unusual markings on him. He's largely white, and then he's got some orange markings, a little bit of an orange tail.
Well, well.
He said, well, I want to explore.
Yes. Not today, honey. Yeah. Sorry.
So he's kind of very different looking. I kind yes. of, you know. And he's got beautiful golden eyes.
Yes.
He is a love bug. Okay. He's just so personable. He's just real interactive kitty. Comes out of his cage, you know, right away. He loves to play. He loves to be pet. Uh-huh. He likes brushing, which is good because he's a medium hair.
He's got a lot of fur.
Yeah, he's got a lot of fur. He's a medium hair. Uh-huh. So he'll need a little extra care with a little extra brushing. Uh-huh. You know, my guess would be he's going to be great in a home, almost any type of a family. I think he'd be great with kids.
How about other cats?
I think he'd be fine with other cats. Okay. He doesn't seem to be bothered by them when he's walking around in the shelter.
Okay.
And, you know, when others are out and he's in his little kennel, he doesn't seem to be bothered by them. I think with appropriate introductions, I think you could probably get him into any home. You know, with a good family, and he'll be comfortable.
Okay.
Okay, you want to walk off the table?
Oh, sure. He said, I'll try anything once.
Yeah.
No. Whoops.
Whoa.
You're out.
Hang on.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. He's a really nice boy.
There we go.
There. That's okay. Yeah.
He's just a great all-around guy.
Yeah.
And, and he's so good-looking.
Yeah, he is.
And very unusual. And he's a little nervous. He's got very pink ears, and they're getting pinker. so his blood pressure's a little bit up because he's nervous here.
Yeah.
But I can't say enough that he's just wonderful. And I think almost any family situation...
Now, we feed Science Diet dry food, and he eats that.
He loves his food.
Okay.
He likes the Science Diet dry. We give him dry food, and then he gets a little bit of treats of wet food.
Wet food.
Mm-hmm. And he loves that, and, you know, an occasional other type of a treat he's good with.
Yeah.
He's just a really good-natured boy.
Yeah, he's not heavy, and we would suggest you try, if you find that yourself adopting him, try not to let him get overweight.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, it's not healthy for any of them. It's not healthy for of them to be overweight. He's a real good weight right now.
Yeah, he is.
When we had him in for his vet checkup, Doc said you were gorgeous. Yeah, Doc said you were gorgeous and you were a perfect weight.
Oh, boy.
And just
a perfect
all-around
cat.
Good guy. Yeah,
he's just waiting for an outlet to go further.
I want to check out this room here.
Yeah.
But he's a good boy.
Yeah,
he's a good boy. So if you think you would be interested in such a beautiful guy as him, you're looking for a good family cat.
Yes.
Somebody that we think with proper introductions could get along with other cats in the household, possibly even a dog.
Or be an only cat,
Or be an only cat. He's just an all-around...
Good boy.
Good boy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he is. He is. And everybody loves him that meets him.
Yeah.
So don't wait around too long before you decide to come and meet him yourself.
Yeah. Now, Strider is not at PetSmart yet.
That's true.
So if you're interested in meeting him... Give us a call on our message line and tell us that you want to meet him, and we'll contact you and make sure that we have him there at whatever adoption day, if it's a Wednesday or a Sunday that you can come in to meet him. We'll make sure we get him there for you.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Okay. Yeah, because he'll be moving. Ooh, he's a good little nub. I've had it.
You've shown me long enough.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because we have, you know, we've got a rotation to get them in, and, you know, so he may not be moving to PetSmart for a while.
Yeah. Anyway. Okay. So this is
Strider.
Yes.
And come meet him.
Yes. Yes. Please do.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you. Good boy.
Good boy. Yeah. Look at this beautiful girl. Look at this. She is just gorgeous. Isn't she?
Isn't she? She is petite. She's about 2.
Okay.
Her name is Tokyo.
Yes. You want to get down?
She's a medium hair.
Why don't you lay here again so we can see you really nicely?
She's got a medium length hair. Mm-hmm. Again, a little bit of extra care. Nice and floofy. She's very soft.
She is.
Black and white little girl. Again, we've got a number of young adults that we'll be showing you. Tokyo's one. Mm-hmm. The next couple of cats we're showing you, I think, are just all around great and would do good.
In any home.
In any home.
She Where are you going, sweetie?
And playful.
Uh-huh.
She does, when she's in her kennel, like to kick her litter around. So I don't know whether she's training for Olympics or what she's doing there.
Uh-huh.
But she makes a little mess in her cage.
Okay. But you know, it's a limited amount of space, too.
She doesn't have much space.
No.
Yeah.
No. So maybe if she had more space, if she had a litter box on the floor and she could just walk into it that way, then it might be a lot better. But we can't guarantee that.
No. So she may be a messy girl, but they have litter mats and things like that that you can put under the under the boxes
but
to collect that.
Pretty?
But isn't she pretty?
Yes, she is.
And she's just an all-around good little girl.
Hi. She sure is.
Yeah, and she's up to date on everything, all her vaccines, all her shots.
Yes.
She's been spayed.
Right,
She's ready to move right into a home.
Look at you. She's got green eyes.
Yeah, she's got pretty little eyes.
Oh, yes.
She's just a love bug.
Yes, she is.
She's just wonderful.
Yes.
She is.
Yep. And I had the opportunity of taking her to the vet last week, and the vet just thought she was gorgeous.
Everybody that meets her says, look at her. She's gorgeous.
Yes, she's so pretty. Yeah, just beautiful. Did you want the mousey, honey?
You want the mouse?
Hey.
No, she said, I want whatever's over there.
Yeah, just.
Yeah. But again, I think almost any type of a household that she'll fit into, again, I think she'd be great with kids.
Yeah.
Teenagers, adults.
Yeah.
She'll probably do pretty well with other cats, again, with proper introductions. She doesn't seem to be bothered by them.
Yeah.
She doesn't seem to be bothered by much of anything.
Yeah.
And
just remember, though, we're saying these cats are kind of neutral and everything, but you'd still need a safe room.
Yeah.
Don't kid yourself.
You still have to do slow introductions and do it the right way. And done the right way, you know, they'll assimilate into your family. See, she's just leaning into my hand there.
And
she's, you know, a little bit longer hair, so a little bit more care, a little bit more brushing so she doesn't knot up. You don't want her to get all knotted and matted. You want her to stay floofy and good looking.
Yep.
Yeah.
She acts like she might like toys.
Yeah, they all want off this table.
Yeah.
There's something in this room that they just think is awesome to go chase around.
Oh, yes.
So if you're interested in Tokyo, again, she's another one of our young adults that has not yet been moved over to PetSmart.
Right.
So give us a call, and we will make sure we have her there to meet you.
Right.
And hopefully you'll maybe could find it. But look at this. She got this cute little spot on her nose.
She's just a cute girl, no matter which way you turn her.
And she's got white whiskers, and she has white eyelashes.
Yes.
Which
and white coming out of her ears.
White
Look at that.
Coming out of her ears. So she's just as cute as can be.
Yeah, she is. Yeah. She is. Okay, so remember her name.
Tokyo.
And give us a call if you'd like to meet her, and we'll make that arrangement real quick.
Absolutely, absolutely. The faster we can get them into their forever homes, the happier we are.
Yes. Yeah. Whoa, playtime.
Playtime.
All right.
Whoa. Okay. All righty. Come meet Tokyo.
Yes.
Okay. Take her home. She's beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now we have a gorgeous lady here. Look at her. Look at her. Now she's a short hair.
She's a short hair calico.
Uh-huh.
Pretty classic calico with the orange, the black, and the white.
Mm-hmm.
She's about 5 years old.
Okay.
And interesting, Paris is her name.
Uh-huh.
And Paris is deaf.
Yeah.
So she startles a little bit when I walk up to her kennel, or if she's, you know, sleeping and she's not, you know, making an eye contact with me, I just tap it gently so she knows that I'm there.
Yes.
Typically, when they're deaf, she doesn't have blue eyes, so
no,
you
she
know,
has
it's
green.
Kind of unusual that that she's deaf. I don't know why.
Hey, can you look at me?
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
She's
settle.
A good girl. She meows very loud. Mm. She cannot hear herself meow. She's kind of like my husband.
He meows loud, too.
He meows loud, too, when he can't hear himself talking. It's
okay.
Like, shh. But she's, she's a real sweet girl.
Yeah. She's very nervous here,
though. Very nervous here, but she's leaning in.
Yeah, she
just loves attention.
Hi.
and she wouldn't need as much brushing. I mean, all of the cats need to be brushed.
Right.
But the two longer hair ones that we had earlier.
Need more.
Need a little bit more. Yeah, and she's just so sweet, and she's kind of tiny. She's a little bit overweight, you know, so we'd want to watch her weight, you know, probably. She should probably be on a light food and exercise, you know, somebody that wants to play with her. She does like to play, and she's just, look at her. She's just snuggling into me.
Yes, she is.
So she's a real good girl. Not as confident with the others that we've had up here on how she'd assimilate with other animals.
Yeah.
And that I think she'd probably be fine.
Yeah. Just give her a little time.
Again, proper introductions. Give her a little bit of time.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, make sure if she's sleeping that you don't, you know, because she startles and then, you know, her reaction is to, you know, to nip because she doesn't know what's going on.
Right.
But a little bit of sound vibration. I understand that they're a lot more in tune to sound vibrations and that around them. That's what I've read.
Okay.
So, you know, just kind of tapping a little when we went to bring her in here. She was asleep in her carrier, and I just kind of very gently tapped her terrier to let her know that I was coming to pick her up.
Yeah.
And I was going to carry her in here.
It's okay.
But she's a sweetheart.
Yes, she
she's
is.
She's young.
Uh-huh.
She's beautiful.
Yes. What more could you ask for?
What more could you ask for?
Yeah. If you want a kitty and short hair besides. I mean, because that's a little bit less work.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So if you're looking for a kitty, she is gorgeous.
She's beautiful.
You're beautiful.
And, you know, the deafness isn't going to bother her one way or the other.
No.
You know, other than she'll just... you know, pick up on vibrations of.
Sure.
I've talked to people that have had deaf cats, and they've said that sometimes think that they're not deaf because they come, when they come home, and you know they run to the door to greet them, and it's like, well, they probably are in tune to the feeling of a garage door opening or doors
and
opening
the time of day
the time of the day, and they figure all that out.
Right.
So. So if you want to meet her again, she's not at PetSmart yet, give us a call.
Yeah.
We'll do whatever we have to do to make a connection so that you can see her and hold her and play with her for yourself.
Yeah. And she is vibrating right now.
Yeah.
She is just happy.
She is.
She's just a happy girl.
She's just a real happy little girl.
Yeah.
So.
And she could probably lose a little bit.
She could lose a little bit of weight.
Yeah. What do you think about that, huh?
She says,
I don't know what you said.
Yeah, I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah. You're a sweetie. You know that? Yes, you are. You are.
Got her.
Oh, yeah, I got her. But she's a handful. You know, you can't let go of her.
Well, not up here on the table. She's not like Bonnie. She's not going to, you know, see, she's loud.
Yeah.
All right. She's wants to be let loose to run around.
Yeah.
And so when she meows really loud.
Yeah.
Okay. She's a sweet pea, so come meet her.
Yes.
Okay, come meet her. Let's find a forever home for her. She's absolutely adorable.
Yeah.
She's got a wonderful personality.
Good girl. Huh? Do you want this toy? Here. Well, that's right. You can't hear
anything.
There. I forget. Anyway, yeah. But she is available, okay? Yeah.
All righty.
All right.
So
thanks,
come
Kathy.
Meet Paris.
Yes. All right. Now we have a gorgeous... another short hair, right?
Another short hair.
Black and white boy.
Black and white boy, about a year to two.
Okay.
His name is Buford.
Hey, want to play?
And he's, they're all gorgeous.
Yeah.
He's very good looking.
Yes, he is.
He's very inquisitive.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, he just loves to explore and look around. And again, he's you know, pretty gentle.
Yeah, probably get into a lot of mischief.
Yeah, he probably would, because he's young. You know, the 1 and 2 year olds, they're still young. They're past the manic kitten stage, but they're still very curious and into things.
Yes.
And
here's another
Buford,
mouse.
Again, I think would be, you know, a
you
good fit for almost any family.
Yeah, I bet he'd be great with kids.
I think he would be. You know, somebody that's got the energy to play with him and get his, you know, let him run and get his energy.
No, no, you can stay up
get
here
his
now.
His energy out. No, I don't want to.
Hey.
Hey. Yeah, that's a good
boy. He's been in the cage for a long time.
Yeah, I've been there. I've been in this carrier for too long, and I want to be out. And he's just kind of toying with me right now. He's not really putting any pressure on. He's just, you know, a little excited and a little nervous.
Sure.
He also has that little black spot on his nose.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah.
I missed that, Buford.
Yeah, that was before, but he's very good looking.
Yes, he is.
I want to play in the room. He wants to run around.
Yeah, that's what he wants.
Yeah, that's what he's looking for. But he's wonderful. I think he'd be good, again, with other cats. I think he'll be good with dogs. I think he'll be good with young kids that want to run him ragged.
Yeah, that'd be great. If you've got some young kids around, we could use them right now.
Yeah.
Hey.
He's a hey. I don't want to be restrained right now.
Yes, Buford, stay.
Yeah, stay here, baby boy.
Yeah. Okay. Well, he's had enough.
He's had enough. He said, "I want to play."
I'm going to get your carrier. Okay?
I'm going to play. Yep. So come meet Buford again. Yes. Another one that is not at PetSmart yet.
Yeah. And we said what? About two?
He's about 1 to 2 years old.
Yeah. So a young guy.
And give us a call and tell us that you want to meet him.
And we'll set it up for you.
And we'll set it up for you.
We have kittens again. Surprise! Babies.
Little babies,
yeah. There are four of them, and they're all the same litter, right, guys?
I believe they are.
Yes. Yep. And do we have any idea how old these babies are?
I'm thinking about three months?
Yeah,
12 or 13 weeks.
Okay.
This is their first public appearance.
Yes.
So
they're shy.
They're shy and hiding.
Yes, they are.
The one that I've got is a little girl. And she's a little calico. Beautiful markings on her. And this is Butterscotch.
Okay.
Yeah, this is Butterscotch. And Butterscotch is very nervous right now.
Oh, so is this little girl.
Can be.
I have another little girl, too, and her name is Eclipse. Huh? You're gorgeous. Yes. Isn't she beautiful?
They're just
Oh, yeah. And their fur is longer. These are not short-haired kittens.
No, they're going to be medium hair, I think.
Yeah.
We have Snowdrop here.
Snowdrop. Jason's got Snowdrop, isn't she? She's pretty, too. Look at the gray on her.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Does she have gray on her paws, too?
Yeah. Well, she's got
a little bit.
On her legs.
Yeah.
She's got a little brown there, a little bit of orange there, and a little orange on the tip of her tail. So she's, you know, like maybe calico.
Yeah.
But, you know, largely gray and white. And she's a shorter hair than the other three.
Yes. And who is this one?
Pixel. That is Pixel. And Pixel is a little boy. Yeah, Pixel is a little boy.
Okay, so that's the only
boy. He's got the medium hair.
In this group.
Yeah, one little boy and three little sisters that he's dominated by.
You've got a lot of fur, little girl.
Yeah,
I'm feeling it all over me.
They do.
All over my face.
This is their first public appearance.
Yes.
So they're nervous. They're in a foster home right now. So if you're interested in meeting these guys, again, you'll have to give us a call.
Look.
And then we'll arrange for the foster mom to bring them in so you can meet them.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, we've had these kittens for a while, and, you know, finally ready to be shown.
Whoa.
They have to be, you know, at least maybe 10 or 12 weeks old to start showing them. And it's more dependent on their vaccine. That they've had at least two of the distemper vaccines, the second series, which is to protect their immunity.
Oh, look, he wants to be by his sister. Isn't that cute?
Yeah.
Yeah. And if you're looking for two, this might not be this might be a good thing to get two who already know each other.
Yeah, sometimes it's helpful to have a bonded pair and someone for a playmate.
Right.
Yeah, someone for playmates and that. And
and these guys don't look alike. Their markings are totally different.
Yeah, very different.
But look they snuggle.
Yeah.
They're bookended, and Snowdrop here is turning into a little cat loaf.
Yeah.
Yes, she is.
And Butterscotch is just not sure.
Yeah.
She was hiding underneath my T-shirt earlier. She
really?
She just didn't want anything to do with the world.
Wow.
But... You know, when they're in their home environment, they're typical kittens.
Ooh.
So they are playful and they are energetic when they're in their environment.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, for first time out, I think they're doing great.
Oh, I agree. Yeah. I agree.
Yeah.
So they're all, every one of them is just more beautiful than the other
one.
Yeah. And look at the fur, the length of fur on this one. I just can't believe how long that is.
Yeah. He's gorgeous. Yeah,
okay. So if you're interested, call us. That's the most we can tell you. Call us,
630-378-4208. Eight. Yes. And leave your name and your phone number, please. And someone will call you back and set up a time when you can come in and actually handle the kittens, play with them a little bit, see what they're really like, and then maybe pick one out or two. Whatever you
Who
think.
Knows?
Yeah.
And give these guys little homes.
Yes.
Yeah, give them for their forever homes. They were, you know, brought in without a mom. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we've been raising them since they were little bitty babies.
Uh-huh. And so they're used to people handling, right?
Oh, they're used to people handling them.
Yeah. Yeah,
they are very used to that. And, you know, they're shy. Kittens, you know, are shy in new environments and,
sure.
you know, manic when they're comfortable. So they're pretty typical kittens.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
And
wow.
We'd certainly like to get them into their forever homes.
Yes, definitely. Oh, you're going to turn her around, huh? There you go.
There they go.
There. Very nice. Very nice. They're all beautiful. Come and meet them in person. You won't be disappointed,
Not
I'm sure.
Not at all. Not yeah. at all.
Well, thank you again for watching today. This is our August show. And we
garage sale.
Oh, yes. Thank you. Our garage sale is coming up. September 15th is the date. It's a Saturday. It's in the parking lot of the Kohl's department store on Boughton Road. And we will, the sale itself opens at 9 and we will be there until
2.
Yes. And if you have things that you would like to donate, we will give you a receipt that you can fill out for that to use for tax purposes. But if not, come and shop. You
yep.
never know yep. what you're going to find.
If you have things to donate, the drop-off time is 7:30 to 9 in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
We ask if you try as best you can to pre-price things.
Yeah.
That way we can get them just dispersed out to the, you know, appropriate tables.
Right.
And the sale itself opens up at 9 o'clock.
Right.
It's our big fundraiser
yes.
for the cats.
Yes.
And, you know, all of the proceeds go to their medical care
yes.
and for feeding them and taking care of them.
Right. I want to add one thing, though. Don't price books and don't price clothing
yeah.
because that will all be priced as a group kind of thing.
Yeah, we kind of.
Because there's so
yeah.
much of it.
Yeah. But anything, no furniture,
right.
no exercise equipment.
Mm-hmm.
Paint, you know, used makeup, things like that.
No televisions.
No televisions, anything like that. Major yeah. appliances, small appliances in good working order.
Right.
You know, we will take, you know, even though it's a garage sale, we, you know, don't want to have somebody spend a couple of dollars for an appliance and then to find home that, you know, they plug it in, it doesn't work at all. So
yeah.
Make sure if you do donate small appliances, they're in good working order.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's good time for the fall.
Yeah.
Clean out
yep.
that garage, clean out that basement.
Right.
Pack it all up for us and bring it on over.
Oh, yeah.
And you can always check our website. We'll always have up-to-date information on map for location, flyers if you want to print out any flyers to share with your friends
mm-hmm.
or just to confirm some of the details that we've had here about what can and can't be donated or when you can drop off or when shopping hours are. So
mm-hmm.
the website www.hhas.org. We will keep a post up there pretty constantly with updated information.
And thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you at the garage sale. Thanks so much.
Don't forget, if you lose your pet, to contact your local authorities immediately. They can help your pet find its way safely home. And remember, a pet is not a toy. It's a lifelong commitment. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next show. Bye-bye.
Bye.